Multiplier graphic approach. In this tutorial, a graphic approach is attempted to show this. Consumption and investment expenditures are measured along the y-axis and national income along the x-axis. Y equal to C plus S is the aggregate supply curve. C plus I is the aggregate demand curve. E is the equilibrium point. Y is the equilibrium income. To begin with, this is the condition. Business people undertake a new investment. Net increase in investment is EA. The aggregate demand curve moves upwards. C1 plus I1 is the new aggregate demand curve. It cuts the aggregate supply curve at E1. The equilibrium income is Y1. The net increase in income is YY1. That is delta Y. According to multiplier principle, YY1 must be greater than EA. But we have to show it graphically. For this, we have to draw a line EN from the point E to the line Y1, E1. This must be parallel to x-axis. EN is equal to Y1. Since aggregate supply curve is a 45-degree line, EN is equal to NE1. Hence, E1N represents change in income, that is delta Y. Curves C plus I and C1 plus I1 are parallel. So EA must be equal to E1M. EN is greater than E1M. This resultant increase in income EN, which is greater than the new investment E1M undertaken, is due to multiplier effect. The multiplier is EN divided by E1M, which is greater than 1. Hence, increase in national income is greater than the initial investment.